shops and restaurants, even some alligator petting, all part of a centennial celebration. Tin City in Naples is celebrating 100 years with an official grand reopening.
The place has been through a lot, both Hurricane Ian's storm surge and a car plowing through it in November. The Night Beat's Annalise Irola is live at Tin City. Annalise, what can people expect at the 100-year celebration and the big grand reopening?
People can expect to have a good time, maybe do a little shopping, stop at one of the restaurants. People here can expect, or people here can celebrate one of the oldest waterfront areas in Naples. There will be face painting, live music, and luxury cars on display, and you can't beat the atmosphere. The first of 3 days of celebration kicked off today.
People know us all across the country.
Tin City has been through a lot. 100 years worth of major events, including Hurricane Ian.
We had 30 businesses out of business. It was kind of like my objective to get everybody open as fast as possible. And I was the one here and kind of spearheaded everything with the help of all the vendors that we had.
Craig Economos is Tin City's property manager.
It was an undertaking, but we got it done in 77 days.
Store owners here like Deborah Underwood and Jen Norqual say Craig and going through Ian together brought everyone closer.
We have become such a family because of him, and there's so much. We're all so invested in Tin City now. It just feels like it was renewed.
Before she owned a store in Tin City, Jen from Docks by Jen came as a kid from Minnesota.
Tin City was like top of the list. We'd run through Tin City, you know, all our fun things to see. To this day, my sister says, I've had a shop 20 years here. My sister's like, can you believe you have a shop at Tin City? Like, it's just iconic.
The history here is rich. Tin City first had oyster processing and a local fishing fleet. The name came from the rustic tin buildings. But now, the waterfront shops and casual old Florida vibe draw in both tourists and locals.
I call this the boardwalk of Naples, because with the little shops and all. And I think that everyone has a great spirit to see the restoration.
Just the shopping, being on the water, the restaurants,
the food.
And events like this. We see baby alligators, and we see a woman on stilts, and we have live music.
Most of the shops have been open for months, but after 100 years of history and surviving Ian, a celebration for this historic Naples destination is well deserved. Tin City's damage from Ian came primarily from the storm surge. There was 3 feet of water damage, but the comeback was fast, and to continue the celebration, city and local officials will be here throughout the weekend, including Senator Pasadomo, for a 1 p.m. ribbon cutting on Saturday. Live on the Night Beat, Annalise Irola, Wink News.